Hello everyone and welcome back to another album review. In this one I'm gonna review Aural Corrosion by OMassacre plus Alex Buess and Merzbow. This is most likely gonna be a short one, so I basically got into this release mainly because there was the name of Merzbow attached to it. I wasn't familiar of OMassacre or Alex Buess prior to this release, so for the most part I got into this completely blind, not knowing what to necessarily expect out of this. And I believe that listening to this, it's a pretty intriguing release when it comes to experimental music. The main album consists of two lengthy tracks, one of them is OMassacre with Alex Buess and the other track is with Merzbow. There is also a CD bonus track, which is a OMassacre solo track, and it's not available on Bandcamp, it's only available if you buy the physical release or digitally. But other than that, it's just a bonus track, so for me the focus would be on the two main tracks, in which I find the first one, Chanting the Resonance of Atrocity with Alex Buess, to actually be an exceptional track when it comes to experimental music. I would actually consider this to be one of the most intriguing and one of the most refreshing tracks when it comes to experimental music that I've heard all year. It is such a well-crafted, almost 18-minute piece that never really becomes boring and is engaging from start to finish. It has this obscure glitchy beat that is kinda noisy, and apart from that it also blends with all of those electroacoustic elements. You have guitars, you have jazzy portions with saxophone and lots of other electronics. It has a nice dark atmosphere to it, going into directions of drone at certain occasions, and it's a track that constantly manages to be engaging and having lots of variety to it, with beat switches, with different melodic portions, but it keeps the main idea for the entirety of the song. So it keeps an identity, making something that would make it feel consistent from start to finish. Certain ideas that you see at the beginning come back later towards the end of the song, and it's really nice to see this track progress the way it does. There is a very nice flow to it, the pacing is really good, it manages in its very lengthy runtime to never become boring, and just introducing new ideas, constantly being refreshing, and just being a really powerful song that in my opinion is very well produced with some really imaginative ideas. And so yeah, for me I would consider this to be one of the greatest stuff when it comes to experimental music that I've heard in recent memory. On the other hand, when it comes to anti-war music with Merzbow, I feel that this track was slightly underwhelming. It is one that focuses on a more minimal beat, but getting to this track, which is also longer, going for almost 21 and a half minutes, it is a track that feels much more flat in comparison, one that doesn't really have the variety that we saw with a previous song, and one that actually becomes kinda repetitive after a certain point. For the most part, you don't see this beat developing even further, and when it comes to Merzbow, you basically have a free improvised noise section over here, which feels pretty similar to something that you would hear out of Merzbow in recent stuff. It doesn't provide something that feels all that much refreshing. It's not something that we haven't heard before, and in my opinion done better. And the mixing of the song ends up feeling kinda weird, as the noise section set up overblowing the beat portion that feels just like it's buried in the background. So you have this more of a focus when it comes to the noise section, but it's mixed in a way where you don't feel like it's all that much dynamic or that it has that many detailed textures. It feels more of like another aspect of the song that serves as being in the background, and so there's nothing that feels like it's that much up front. There are a few intriguing parts here and there, and it feels like there are certain sections where you can see similarities and that there is an attempt to have something attached to them as ideas and concepts, but for the most part it feels more of like a mess of a song. And so it leaves me in a weird position, as I consider the very first song to be an exceptional piece, a really refreshing song when it comes to experimental music. On the other hand, I find the second track to be somewhat interesting, but for the most part it felt underwhelming. So it leaves me in a position where I'm towards the middle. I was hoping that this release was gonna be even better. The very first song prepared me for something even greater, but the second track kinda ruins it, but not in a way where I would say it ruins the whole experience. Overall though, I'd say that this is a recommendation. It's a pretty intriguing release with some cool stuff to it, and I think that when it comes to experimental electronic music, there are some really interesting aspects about this album. I'm gonna give Aural Corrosion a 7+ out of 10. What's your opinion on this album? Like it, dislike it, why? And what do you want to review next time? Let me know down in the comments. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video, subscribe for more content like this. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video. Goodbye.